We continue our coverage with the news that we told you yesterday concerning the closure of the Fairmont Regional Medical Center. Emily McNamara joins us now. She's in our newsroom. She has the latest from today. Good evening, Emily.
Dawn, today I spoke with Delegate Michael Angelucci about the effect this decision will have on EMS transport for patients, along with a petition to have Fairmont Regional's parent company, Elekto, investigated.
With the news of Fairmont Regional Medical Center closing, Marion County EMS has already been planning its next steps. With the hospital closing, they will have to transport people to the closest emergency room by the mile. Those would be United Hospital Center, Ruby Memorial Hospital, or Mon Health.
Patients, for example, that are suffering from life-threatening injuries or illnesses and cardiac arrest, imagine tacking on 25, 30, 45 minutes to the next closest facility because Fairmont is closed. That's the difference between life and death. That's what's so frustrating for me, to see that Elekto has put money over the health care of our citizens.
Delegates Mike Caputo, Linda Launstreth, and Michael Angelucci said enough is enough and sent a letter to Attorney General Patrick Morrissey today to open an investigation on Elekto.
We've seen a pattern from Elekto that they're coming in, they're buying up rural hospitals, they're taking the profits, running them into the ground, and then leaving us high and dry. That's what they did at East Ohio Valley Regional. That's what they did at Ohio Valley Medical Center. And now that's what they've done at Fairmont Regional. And so we think it's time that the Attorney General takes a look into their business practices, because what they are doing is jeopardizing the health care of the people of the state of West Virginia.
As delegates and officials continue to fight for the hospital, Angelucci and Marion County EMS are preparing for anything to come at any given time.
I've been involved in EMS now for 20 years, and I never dreamed that I would see the day that we would be dealing with this type of situation. It's shameful to see what Elekto has done to our community. Our organization has been around since 1972, and I'm going to ensure all of our staff are going to ensure that we continue to provide quality care to the people of Marion County. That's what they deserve, that's what they expect, and that's what they're certainly going to get.
Angelucci mentioned when Ohio Valley Medical Center closed, it was also given a 60-day notice. And one random day in that time period, the emergency squad was told it only had until midnight that day. He says they will stay alert and on top of these things if it were to happen, but they are definitely not throwing in the towel anytime soon. Reporting in the 12 Newsroom, I'm Emily McNamara.